Hello students, in the previous video we have seen the same topic adverb and how we can form an adverb by an adjective. And in this the fourth part of the same topic, and now in this part I am going to tell you the comparison of adverbs like adjectives. Adverbs have the same comparison, so you have to know how the adverbs are compared in the same degrees like adjectives. So in this way you can see that some adverbs are compared just like an adjectives, and they do have the same degrees: positive, comparative and superlative as the adjective. Like adjectives, adverbs have the same degrees of comparison, and that is positive degree, and the second is comparative degree, and the third and last is the superlative degree. So to know more about this topic, you have to know some more rules how we can form a comparative and superlative degree from the positive degree of the adverb. So here is the rules. You have to watch it carefully and related examples. You have to watch it very carefully, which I am going to tell you. And here is the first rule, and that is adverb of one syllable. Adverb which belongs to one syllable form their comparative and comparative by adding er and superlative degree by est. It means adverb which belongs to one syllable forms its comparative by adding er to the positive and est to the superlative degree. To know more about these rules, you have to see some examples related to the same topic, and that is fast. Here is the first example. Fast, it's an adverb in its positive degree, and if we can form a comparative degree from the positive degree, its comparative degree will be faster, and we have to add er in the positive degree, and fastest is the superlative degree, and we have to add the est into the positive degree. So you can say that adverb which belong to one syllable form its comparative degree by adding er to the positive and est to the superlative, such as fast, faster, fastest. Here is the second example, high. It's also an adverb related to one syllable, and its comparative degree will be higher. We have to add er, and its comparative degree is the highest. We have to add the est to the positive degree. The third example is hard, and if we want to form the comparative degree of the same adverb, we have to add er into the positive degree. It will be harder. And if you want to form the superlative degree of the same adverb hard, we have to add the est into the positive degree, and it will be hardest. Hard is the positive degree, harder is the comparative degree, and hardest is the superlative degree. Here is the fourth example, that is no. It's also an adverb, belong to one syllable, and its comparative degree will be formed by adding er, and it will be lower, and its superlative degree will be lowest. We have to add the est into its positive degree. And here is the next example, that is near. It also belongs to one syllable. The particular adverb also belongs to one syllable, so we have to add er to form a comparative degree, and it will be nearer. And if we want to form the superlative degree from the same adverb, we have to add the est into the positive degree, and it will be nearest. Near is the positive degree, nearer is the comparative degree, nearest is the superlative degree, such as long, longer, longest, soon, sooner, soonest. These are the adverbs belongs to one syllable. So we can say that students, adverbs which belong to one syllable form its comparative degree by adding er and superlative degree by adding est into its positive form. This is the first rules how we can form an adverb, or how we can form the degree of comparison, comparative and positive degree. And here is the second rules, and that is adverbs that belong to or more than two syllables. There are so many adverbs in English grammar which belongs to two or more than two syllables, and if we want to form the comparative and superlative degree of the same adverbs, then we have to add more, the underline. We have to consider the underline word more to form its comparative degree, and most, and most to form superlative degree. More is added to form comparative degree, and most is added to form a superlative degree. To know more about the second rules, you have to see some more examples related to the same topic. And here is the examples. Here are some more examples. That is, the first example is kindly. It's an adjective which belongs to more than, it's an adverb which belongs to more than two syllables. So we have to add the more to form its comparative, and it will be more kindly. And if we want to form the superlative degree of the same adverb, we have to add the most, and its superlative degree will be the most kindly. So kindly is the super, is the positive degree. More kindly is the comparative degree, and most kindly is the superlative degree. Here in the same way, the second example, skillfully, is also an adverb which belong two or more than two syllables. So we can form the comparative degree by adding more, and it will be more skillfully. And we have to form the word most to form superlative degree, and it will be most skillfully. Foolishly, comparative degree will be more foolishly, and superlative degree will be most foolishly. Slowly, if this is also an adverb which belong to or more than two syllables, so we have to add more, the word more to form its comparative degree, and the word most to form its superlative degree. So slowly is the positive degree, more slowly is the comparative degree, and most slowly is the superlative degree of an adverb. Here is the fifth example, and that is clearly. Here is the same adverb belong to or more than two syllables. So we have to add more to form its comparative degree, and it will be more clearly and superlative degree by adding most, and it will be most clearly. So clearly is the positive degree, more clearly is the comparative degree, and most clearly is the superlative degree. So students, you can say that adverb which belong to more than two syllables form its comparative by adding more, and superlative by adding most. And we have to see the some more examples. And here is the third rules how we can form comparative and superlative degree. And this is the sum. Adverbs form the degree of comparison in an irregular way. Some adverbs in English grammar form its comparative and superlative degree in an irregular way. For the example, we can say that here is the well, good. This is the positive degree, and its comparative degree will be better, superlative degree will be best. Here in the same way, ill or badly, these are the positive degree, and its comparative degree will be worse, and superlative degree will be worse. So you can see that the positive degree of an adverb, if you want to form the comparative and superlative degree, then it has a totally different form. And here is the examples. In the same way, here is the third example, little. Its comparative degree will be less, and superlative degree degree will be less. Late, its comparative degree will be later, and superlative degree will be last. Sorry, last. And here is the next rules. Next example. So positive degree is much, comparative degree will be more, and superlative degree will be most. And here is the important example for. It is used both as well as for in the sense of place as well as time. And if it is both used in the same sense, its comparative degree will be further and superlative degree will be for best. And if the same word for is used in the sentence in the sense of place, then its comparative degree will be farther and its superlative degree will be farthest. This is the third rules how we can form a comparative and superlative degree of an adverb from its positive. And here are some more examples related to the same rules. And here is the next and the last rules how we can form the comparative and superlative degree of adverb from the positive degree. And that is, if there are some many adverb and if the same adverb gives the negative meaning in the sentence, and if we want to change them into comparative and superlative degree, then we have to add the word less to form the comparative degree and the word less to form the superlative degree. If the adverb, you have to see the fourth rules very carefully. That is, if the adverb gives the negative meaning in the sentence, then we have to form less, the word less to form a comparative degree and the word less to form a superlative degree. And here are some more examples related to the same rules. And the first one is clearly. Here is the word clearly. And if the particular word is used to denote the negative meaning in the sentence, then we have to add less to form its comparative degree and less to form its superlative degree. So clearly is the positive degree, less clearly is the comparative degree, and less clearly is the superlative degree. And it always gives the sense of negative meaning in the sentence. Here is the same way, wisely is the positive degree, and if you want to form the comparative degree to denote the sense of negative meaning, it will be less wisely, and superlative degree will be the less wisely. And the third rule is forcefully. And if the particular word or adverb want to denote the negative meaning in the sentence, we have to add the less to form its comparative degree, and it will be less forcefully. Superlative degree will be less forcefully. Painfully, its comparative degree will be less painfully, and superlative degree will be less painfully. And here is the fifth example, and that is, if the adverb hopefully is used in the sentence, and if it want to denote the negative meaning in the sentence, then we have to form less to form comparative degree and less to form superlative degree of the same adverbs. So here is the fourth rule, and that is, to form a negative meaning of any adverb, to form negative meaning of an adverb, we have to add less to form the comparative degree, and less is to form the superlative degree of the adverb. And students, these are the rules how we can form comparative and superlative degree of adverbs, and some more examples related to the same rules. And you have to watch it very clearly for yourselves. And that's it like that. Okay, students?